lots of things I want to talk about in this tank that I'll share a little bit later.
Hey, what's up, Reefers? Very, very exciting day today. Today is the Mason Dixon Reef Club Frag Swap. I usually get corals a few different ways, including buying from store, buying from reef clubs. Local Frag Swap has always been the most affordable way and most diverse way of getting corals. Today is probably one of my last big Frag Swap before something arrives. Ready to get going? Let's go. Don't act like you're not in the bathroom.
My shopping bags.
Your last chance.
By the way, we're spreading awareness today. Beware of palytoxin. This is a hilarious shirt. So the designer signed it to me a couple months ago, I believe it's on Amazon. I'll put a link in the video description below if you're interested. But let's go spread some awareness.
First off,
alright guys, here we are. We're gonna go in with the small cooler first, and as needed, we'll bust out the big rolling cooler. Back here one more time at that pat place, that fish place. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Machine.
Two?
Yo, what's going on, Dan?
I haven't seen you so long.
Hi.
Congratulations on the store.
Thank you.
What's going on?
How you doing, man? Congratulations on the new one.
And his Emily, of course.
Hi.
That guy back there, he gets like the best zoas, best price and stuff like that. So usually as soon as it's open, people just go all to him. And I think like within the first half hour, an hour, all of this stuff is all gone.
What's Bookie's budget today?
400?
500. Oh.
Whatever you got.
Oh, we're going to check up puppies after this.
Yes.
It's like whatever you want to get.
Yeah.
It's pretty close by.
I think. Yeah.
Okay. Just T5s then?
Yes, yeah. T5 ball. Yep.
Notice his gaze. Notice his gaze, Daniel.
It's something that, like I said, it'll speak to you in your tank. You're going to have this piece, and it's going to become your favorite piece.
He's got one of his
tanks. That's nice.
They can powder bank. You don't have one.
That is nice.
But this is an 8-can?
Yep. Yeah.
They call it like a power bank, banky.
It's a very large 8-can body. So like normally on like a Micro Musa is very small, and an 8-can Lord are these. And that's the 8-can power.
I put a camera out, you gotta get something now.
No. Just like hashtag enabler.
This guy is a real enabler right here.
No, not even.
He's into his
What are we looking at?
These guys right here.
That one's
really nice.
Those are nice though.
I like how Daniel's like, my wife's gonna kill me. And I was like, I'll take that one.
I'll take this one.
Yeah, he pulled out the car. He's ready to go, man.
Yeah, I'm still looking at
it. One eternity later.
I actually bought a lot of stuff. I didn't really film too much as I was buying stuff, but we'll go over what I purchased really shortly. Emily, why are you so happy?
So we're talking about dogs and the corals.
Because corals! Corals!
Can't even close it.
Yeah!
Look at Alex working. Alex working. Working hard.
Look at that. Look at that cooler.
This is the only thing that Dan picked up today.
It is. OG Bounce,
nice. How much is this?
Got a deal, $75.
It's actually a really good price.
That's a good deal.
That's an amazing deal, and that's an OG.
I know. Hopefully I don't kill this one too.
All right, so now we're gonna check
out. It's He's asking a pregnant woman to walk reversed.
All right, so we got the saltwater stuff. Now we're gonna check out the store and pick some of the freshwater stuff.
Wait, Moki, should I open up Mobius?
Oh, what is a Mobius to speak of?
I don't know. I can't either confirm nor deny.
Yo, is that a trident? Oh, that is a trident.
Jim did it. Jim did it.
We got this one for display.
Yeah, Moki's going big now.
He's going professional.
You're gonna upgrade the thing out like, along?
Yeah, you together right here.
Yeah,
like dark white in the middle.
I mean, he's been doing it for a while.
Kind of like this. Like when you just have it like this.
Yeah.
Maybe even just like a couple small pieces like this and just like.
1 hour later.
Nice, he's a good boy. We're trying to restock the 9-gallon find the tank. This is ticket. Thought about maybe Dragonstone, but this is kind of more straightforward, and we can go for the jungle look that I really like.
Bebe.
Alex just hooked me up with this. What is this?
This is your new RF chip that you're gonna be replacing the green RF chip in MP10.
MP10.
Right? And it's gonna help you hook up to Mobius. wirelessly.
What is Mobius?
Oh, I don't know. We'll have to stay tuned for some Mobius.
So people give me crap about arriving late. Look at this guy. Watch out, you got a car behind you as well.
Why are you leaving me, man?
Why are we leaving you?
Same designer, right? Your shirt? Or is
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
It's cool.
Perkin OC.
Perkin OC.
Oh, we're teammates.
Twinsies.
Where are we going? Why are there horses on the road?
Why?
I'm in Amish country.
They got a better BMW, babe.
1 hour.
Wait, I think we're here.
Oh, so cute.
All right, Reefer's just got home. Man, what a long drive, but let's take a look and check out the haul from today. First of all, we picked up some Chados for Jim. That's from Hunter. Another really nice SPS. It's supposed to be a surprise, but see this video afterwards. Saw some really nice snails. We got some Estrus snails. It's $6 for $5, so I picked up 12 of them. We've got some nice beefy Sarah snails. These are the ones that go under the sand. Also $6 for $5. Oh yeah, here's a good one. I believe this is Japanese whipping willow. So these tentacles do not get as long as a 10 version, but they do get long and is a bright green. So I'm really looking forward to this. I remember it's $50. Okay, this is, I think, something wine, Zoas. I thought it would look nice in the 10 gallon budget. Look at this nice chunky Acan Lord. This is $40, immediately poke it. I was just like, I just bag it up. Look how chunky it is. You can't really see the whole thing, but once again, this will go into the 10 gallon budget nano and we'll take a closer look. Here is another really nice Acan Lord mini colony for $20, if I remember right. This $20. And over here, we got a type of chalice. I don't remember exactly what it's called, but I know I've been eyeing this kind of coloration for a while. And last, but certainly not least, we got this guy right here. This is actually a plating sponge. I had a smaller one in the 45 that was doing well for a while and it disappeared. But I saw it again for $20. Had to pick it up. Look how beautiful it is. It looks almost like a Monty cap, except when the flow hits it, it kind of moves around a little bit. So people are like, what? And also, real interesting, I didn't know they have Ziploc bag that comes in this size. This makes the perfect Frag bag, doesn't it? Look at that. Like, that's a regular bag. And here's a Ziploc version. Pretty cool. And since we have the box here, I just wanna kind of give a shout out to all the other content creator that sent me the sticker. Look at this. I'm filling up really nicely. So thank you guys for sending me your stickers. Pretty new to the sticker game, but making out pretty well. Let's add the corals to the tank.
3 days later.
All right, guys, it has been about 4 or 5 days since the frag swap. I just want to give you a quick update on the stuff that I picked up. First of all, we got some of these snails right here. We got a Seraph snails going strong. We got the Estrus snails going strong right there. And we got some in the back as well, so that's doing good. One of the Seraph snails has been in a mortal combat with a Scarlet Hermit. They've been locked in this position for about, I think, 2 or 3 days already. I think maybe the Seraph snail may have passed on and the Scarlet Hermit keep trying to get to the quote-unquote meat, but just not having much luck. I try moving them around, but Scarlet Hermit always end up here. So I think it is dead set on trying to get to the meat as well as the shell. So I'm just gonna leave them be. Two corals that came into this tank is this really nice chalice. I'm not too sure what kind of chalice it is, but I really like it. Seems to be doing well, but it's also super aggressive. You notice that I moved the Fahadendro down here. It used to be over there, but overnight, I think this chalice sent a stinger and it totally destroyed two of the polyp on the other side. So I immediately moved over here and it seems to be recovering fine. The other piece of not really coral, but this is actually a plating sponge I picked up from the swap. I moved it here hoping that eventually it's gonna start growing onto the rock. Now, to be fair, I should probably move this into the shade just so that there's no risk of algae growing on the sponge. But so far it seems okay. I mean, this is not really direct light. The corals and the rock seems to be blocking some of the light, so hopefully it should be okay. So I'll leave this here and see if it'll spread. Side notes, I also got this chalice as well as the Space Invader back from Mr. Telegram, Jim, my reef sensei. But I'll talk a little bit more about those in a later video because those got stories of its own. And I'll probably do a really nice 45 gallon update because a lot of things has changed. I even changed up the rock structure. I'm not sure if some of you guys can see it. But yeah, again, lots of things I want to talk about in this tank that I'll share a little bit later. Let's go upstairs to the budget nano where most of the action's happening and I'll show you what's going on. All right guys, here's our 10 gallon budget nano reef. I have to flow off because I was feeding the tank. First, let's start from here. This is the $25 A-can that I picked up and here is the really nice $40 one. That's actually one of my favorite peas from this swap. It just looks so fat and happy. Sliding up there, we got a really, really special Japanese green whipping willow leather. I'm really looking forward to see how this piece develops. Now, like mentioned before, the tentacle is not as long as the standard whipping willow, but then it does have that really nice green neon color, so that should look nice once it gets a little bit larger. We got our final piece that is, I think it's like red wine or something like that. Zoas. It actually looks really similar to the Space Monster, so I just kind of park them next to each other and see how they do. And that kind of concludes all the frag that I picked up from the Mason Dixon Reef Club Frag Swap. As always, it has been a joy to hang out with the buddies at the Frag Swap as well as picking up all these nice, affordable frag pieces. If you have frag swap like this happening locally where you live, I highly recommend checking it out. If not, if you guys have like local reef club, definitely check out the meeting as well because like a lot of people will be number one talking shop and number two they'll be selling overgrown corals at these kind of meetings, and I feel like it's a fantastic way to stock up your tank. If I do not buy corals from these swaps and from other people and just solely relying on stores or online online orders, I can definitely get similar pieces, but I may be paying a little bit more because they do have overhead, so it's justified, extra cost. But that's just one other avenue that I get my corals from. I think in the next video or two, I'm gonna talk a little bit more in depth about this 10 gallon budget nano reef. It has been a joy and I've learned a lot. And I've tweaked my method a little bit once I figure out what works and what does not. I'll be really happy to share with you guys. But in the meantime, just this is a sneak peek. That little frag of A-can's not doing well, and I know exactly why, as well as that Zoa and that one is not really opening up fully, but I also have a theory of what I can do to make it open up. And that's why I kind of want to wait a week or two. So I'm going to apply what I think is going on and see if it fixes the problem. If so, then I know exactly what to tell you guys. All right, guys, that'll do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you liked it, be sure to leave a like on the way out so I know that you guys enjoyed this kind of content. Otherwise, I'll see you guys next Sunday at 12:30 p.m. sharp. And just like that, tank is drained.